Hey guys, welcome back to Electrical Car Repair Live. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. Today will be super helpful video guys to any of you having a Kia Sportage, Kia Sorento guys, and you're trying to remove or replace AC compressor guys. Stay with us, we'll explain how to do that on a 2.4 GDI engine guys that has been used in both of these vehicles. You don't need to remove your engine to do that. We simply have it out due to the fact that we'll be making hundreds of videos that can potentially save you thousands of dollars. And with the engine being out, we can clearly guys show you where everything is located, how to remove, how to replace certain components, and where every single body is located. So let's explain how to replace that compressor now. So this should work on Kia Sportage and Kia Sorento different years. For instance, they start using it in early 2012 all the way to 2016-17 depending on the market guys. That's a 2.4 GDI engine. So before we start, let me introduce you to the channel. Every single car we get at the garage guys, we take them completely apart and we make at least 200 to 300 free repair videos. Why we do all that? Simply because our mission in the shop is to save you as much money as we can. All we need in return, please subscribe to the channel, like the video, that way we can keep providing this free information to you. Also guys, if you want to buy parts or tools for a really good price and quick shipping as well, check out the link in the description of the video below and you can see where we get all our tools and parts from. Specifically, this is an engine out of a 2013 in Kia that we'll be demonstrating on. And with that being said, okay, if you have a Kia guys or other vehicle, check our main channel Auto Repair guys. We have videos that have helped more than 120 million people guys that can save you thousands of dollars. So let's start on it now. So this is guys right here, the engine, 2.4 GDI engine that we'll be working on. Now let me guys show you where the AC compressor is and what we need to do. This is guys your AC compressor. You can see you have the serpentine belt right here, AC compressor, alternator, crankshaft. So that's the AC compressor that we'll need to remove. That you will have your AC lines right here. Now, you cannot just go ahead and remove the AC compressor due to the fact that your AC system will be full of Freon under enormous amount of pressure. And if you remove the hoses, Freon can leak anywhere, guys. It can blind you, it can spray on you, so don't do that, okay? So, the correct way to do is, you can see you have two ports, high pressure, low pressure port. Take it to an AC shop or a garage, guys, and for a small fee, they can empty your AC system. It's called to vacuum the AC system. They just suck all the Freon out. If you let it in the atmosphere guys, if you release it in the atmosphere through the valve, you can get a big fine and you're killing the atmosphere, so do not do that. Once it's empty guys, okay, you can find a video even how to empty it, and I can put a link to a machine that can actually guys do it for you, okay, which is not too expensive as well. You can go ahead and continue guys. Make sure, okay, that the engine is not spinning, anything like that. You'll be working with the belts, make sure engine's turned off. I'll even recommend even to disconnect the car battery in some cases. This is guys right here, the tensioner. We'll first need to remove the serpentine belt. So we go counterclockwise with a 14 millimeter wrench. It's spring loaded, okay, and just release the belt. Okay, the moment the belt comes off, we can continue with the next step. Now, the AC compressor will have one wire. You don't have a clutch, guys, okay? You will notice that many models do not have a clutch. Some models may have, but this one doesn't have a clutch. It's only controlled by the AC compressor valve. So you have a wire right there. You have a holder that you need to pull out of the compressor. We need to disconnect the wire. So right there, I'm going to press down here. Okay, press down here and pull out. Perfect. Now we need to guys remove the AC lines. So they have 10 millimeter nuts, one here, one there. One is high pressure, the little pipe is known as a high pressure, the thick pipe is known as a low pressure pipe. Make sure the system is empty again. Okay, you can always connect the gauge, okay, and read the pressure if you're in doubt. So that's what we're doing now. Alright, working on the second one now. And once we get them loose, okay, these lines should be able to pull them out. Okay, you may leak a little bit of AC oil out. Perfect. Now we can grab the second one and pull that one as well. We're going to remove the radiators and stuff so we can show you everything, okay, with a great detail, guys. Okay, where that, where the bolts are and all that stuff. So we'll go ahead. We have four bolts, with a 12 millimeter socket. On the last one, hold the compressor because it can drop on you and it's heavy. Okay, even though it has guides, sometimes they could be broken, missing, so always hold it, because that thing, if you're laying under the car, you will be doing all that from under the vehicle, guys, from underneath. Okay, it will fall on you and it can seriously hurt you. You can see that's where it gets stuck. Okay, to the engine block. So, not actually the engine block, that's the bracket under the alternator that holds the alternator as well. So that's how you guys remove the AC compressor. That's how you replace it. Putting it together is in reverse order. We took it apart. If you need to see the how to recharge the system, we'll have a video. We'll have a video how to replace the AC compressor valve, because that often causes the AC compressor not to work. We'll have a video how to rebuild an AC compressor or AC compressor that's locked up on our main YouTube channel, How to Repair, guys. Please check it out. Also, if you want to see the top 5 things why AC doesn't work on Hyundai, on Kia Sportage, Kia Sorento, guys, it will work as well. That same compressor actually has been used on Hyundais and Kias and many of the parts, and that's why sometimes I still get confused. You can see it says Hyundai Kia on most of the parts, because the same engine has been used in some Hyundai vehicles as well. Hopefully the video will be helpful. Thank you for watching and see you next time.